there are some pitfalls that everyone using C++ should know, and I'm not talking about common things like dereferencing a null pointer. I want to talk about some rare weird problems, like stack corruption or global initialization fiasco, that if you are serious about using C++, you will encounter at some point, and if you don't know about them, they can take from hours to days to fix. The last one literally took me like 2 days to fix, and probably 1 year to notice in the first place. So watch this video till the end, because it will save you hours of debugging and headbanging, so let's go. I will start with maybe the simplest one, and that is undefined behavior. So many things in C++ are considered undefined behavior. Dereferencing a null pointer is, forgetting to return from a function is, and accessing an initialized variable is. So you should always initialize your variables. But here is the thing. Once you do something that is undefined behavior, your program can just break. Or it cannot break. In fact, anything can happen. It can break on another machine, but on your machine it could run just fine. Now, the only tip I can give you here, besides always initializing your variables, is that if your program crashes randomly in weird places, or just behaves in weird ways, like you check your ifs, but it still behaves like it is a quantum computer and the variable is both true and false at the same time. Maybe you have undefined behavior. Like you correctly calculated your value, but you forgot to return it from the function. That happened to me many times, and many of the things that I will show next are undefined behavior. So keep in mind that with undefined behavior, anything goes. Your program can break in weird ways, or it cannot break at all, or it can break in debug mode, but not in release mode. So moving up in complexity, buffer overflow is also an undefined behavior. But the result could be that by overflowing the buffer, you accidentally write into some other variables. So here is the thing. Let's say you have a variable and you set its value, but when you print it, it just has another value. In a weird case like this, you should check if you modified it accidentally or if you passed the wrong variable. But if you don't find the problem, you should probably expect the worst, which is that you are writing in memory in the wrong place. This can be the simple buffer overflow that I just showed, or it can be something way harder to find, like you are writing in deleted memory. Or maybe you casted the pointer wrongly. But here is the thing. If you see a symptom somewhere, like a variable having the wrong value, the problem could actually be somewhere else. So after you investigate the things related to the symptom, try to investigate in a different place, because you might have a bug somewhere else that writes wrongly into memory. Pro tip. You can set a breakpoint when a variable changes, so this could help you find the bug. Also, try what I call stalling debugging, which I show in this video. Basically, comment out parts of the code and see if that fixes the problem. If so, that means that you have potentially found where the problem comes from. And there's another rule of thumb. Never assume you know what the problem is. You might guess wrong. Okay, but now that this buffer overflow wasn't that bad, let me show you a bad example of a buffer overflow. So we get an error. No problem. Let's see where it came from. And not only doesn't came from our code necessarily, but it comes from a place that shouldn't have any reason to throw an error. What's going on? Well, this is a stack corruption. So we just did a buffer overflow, as in the last example, or wrote to some memory in the wrong place, but the symptoms here are way more horrible. Basically, by accident, we wrote into the stack of the program, and in the stack, we also have things related to function calls. So by corrupting the stack, we can get weird errors when we exit from a function. Unfortunately, this is hard to debug. But if you see symptoms, expect the worst and try to check your memory and buffer accesses. If you find anything suspicious, comment it out and see if the bug disappears. The problem might be there. Also, to be clear, sometimes you'll get nice error messages, and adding a sanitize address option to the linker and the compiler will probably help. But sometimes you'll get less obvious error messages, and this is what happened to me. But I was lucky, because after trying to reproduce this bug to show it to you, I noticed that the common case is the program crashing with absolutely no error messages. So if you ever see that, look for memory access problems. Okay, two more things. So sometimes you add an include file and your code breaks and you get like 50 compile errors. This is because of circular includes, which I also explained in more detail in this video. But basically the idea is this. Main.cpp includes a.age. a.age includes b.age before defining a. And b.age includes a.age back, but it can't be included again. So from here on, b doesn't know what the a class is. The solution to things like this is to forward declare the class. Also, in general, try to keep a few things in a header file, and forward declare in the header file as much as possible instead of including files. Forward declare works only if you use the reference of the class, so you can't use it every time. Okay, and the last one. This actually happened to me in my Steam game. So, see these particles here? Well, sometimes, and I mean only rarely, I open the game and they are black instead of colored. And that's why it took me like one whole year to notice, because it happened only sometimes. Undefined behavior at its finest. And the problem was global initialization fiasco or static creation order. Basically, I had two global variables, some colors and a list of colors for arrows. Here is the thing, because these two things were in different files, the initialization order was undefined. So usually, the colors would be initialized first, and then they would be placed in the array. But sometimes, the array would be initialized first, and since the colors weren't initialized, I would get zeros instead. The solution was to use constexpr variables or macros. Initially, I wanted to use macros, because constexpr wasn't possible in my case, but I wanted to be a cool guy and not use macros because they are evil. But not using them broke my code, and I returned to using macros for the code to fix it. So are they evil? You decide. If you found this video useful, share it with someone like you, and now you should probably also check out this video about debugging, so I can help you even more. See you!